Hello, welcome to the Staff Talent Show. I'm Jenny Thompson, Chair of the Great River School Foundation. Our foundation supports the long-term financial needs of Great River School so that for many years to come, our public Montessori school can prepare students for their unique roles as responsible and engaged citizens of the world. Here are some of the ways Great River School is supporting our staff, students, and families right now. We helped Great River students and families create learning environments in their homes. We've invested $7,000 to help families get internet services and $20,000 in laptop computers to loan to students without computer technology at home. We're keeping all staff employed, even though we've lost significant income from our aftercare programs, school lunch offerings, and upcoming summer programs. Our amazing nutrition staff continues to provide meals for families in need. They have launched a widely successful Heron to Go service that offers made from scratch meals with curbside pickup. Our teaching staff has created distance learning that's holistic and student centered, while also providing support for caregivers. Great River's response to the COVID-19 crisis has put unexpected demands on our school budget. If this is a hard time for you financially, we understand, and we thank you for all that you do. If you can give right now, please do. If you can give double, this is the time. GRS needs you. You can give through the online auction, get there through the blue Go to Auction button above this video, where you can place bids on amazing community donated goods. You can also give directly to the school by clicking a blue donate button above this video or by texting GOATS to 91999. One last thing, please consider becoming a monthly sustainer in any amount. That's the best way for Great River to have predictable sources of support so we can offer this amazing education to all students. Here's my own Great River alum now. Go Stars!
Go Stars!
Hello, Great River School community. That is an actual loon on an actual lake, and I'm here to say that for every $1,000 we raise at the Blue Heron Bash, over $10,000, I will jump into this 41-degree lake, and you can watch me bob my head up and say how many thousands we've raised. So that's right, the first time we hit $11,000, I, in my full attire, will be jumping into this cold lake. So please find it in your generosity to help us out. And thanks for your support for Great River School.
Hi, welcome to the Blue Heron Bash. I'm Holly of the front desk, and I'll be your MC. I'm glad you're here. Please make yourself comfortable. We have two talent shows for your entertainment as you place your bids and watch your competition. One show is made up of staff representing the elementary wing, the other staff from the adolescent wing, and you'll notice some admin people sprinkled throughout. I hope you enjoy your time here, and do keep an eye on your bids, because I'm going to be bidding while you're watching the talent shows. All right, so on we go. First up, for the elementary team, we have Jessie, and Jessie's going to show us her amazing talent for memory work. Here we go, Jessie.
Hey, Great River. I'm going to sing a song that's a favorite song in our community. It's not going to sound as fun without the kids, though. And it's called The Rattlin' Bog. And if I were super brave, I would do it in my Scottish accent, but I'm not. But this is how it goes. Oh ho, the rattling bog, the bog down in the valley, oh. Oh ho, the rattling bog, the bog down in the valley, oh. And in that bog there was a hole, a rare hole, a rattling hole in the hole in the bog, and the bog down in the valley, oh. Oh ho, the rattling bog, the bog down in the valley, oh. Oh ho, the rattling bog, the bog down in the valley, oh. And in that hole there was a tree, a rare tree, a rattling tree. The tree in the hole in the hole in the bog, and the bog down in the valley, oh. Oh ho, the rattling bog, the bog down in the valley. valley, oh, 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 the rattling bog, the bog down in the valley, oh. And on that tree there was a branch, a rare branch, a rattling branch, and the branch and the tree and the tree and the hole and the bog down in the valley, oh, oh, ho, oh, the rattling bog, the bog down in the valley, oh, oh, ho, oh, the rattling bog, the bog down in the valley, oh. And on that branch there was a twig, a rare twig, a rattling twig, and the twig and the branch and the branch and the tree and the tree and the hole and the bog and the bog down in the valley, oh, oh, ho, oh, the rattling bog, the bog down in the valley, oh, oh, ho, oh, the rattling bog, the bog down in the valley, oh. And on that twig there was a leaf, a rare leaf, a rattling leaf, and the leaf on the branch and the branch, oops, a leaf on the twig and the twig and the branch and the branch and the tree and the tree and the hole and the bog down in the valley, oh. Oh, ho, oh, the rattling bog, the bog down in the valley, oh. Oh, ho, oh, the rattling bog, the bog down in the valley, oh. And on that leaf there was a nest, a rare nest, a rattling nest, and a nest on the leaf, and the leaf on the twig, and the twig on the branch, and the tree, and the hole, hole in the bog down in the valley, oh. Oh, ho, oh, the rattling bog, the bog down in the valley, oh. Oh, ho, oh, the rattling bog, the bog down in the valley, oh. Usually the kids will start singing for me when I start losing my breath. Okay. And on that nest there was an egg, a rare egg, a rattling egg, and the egg on the nest, and the nest on the leaf, and the leaf on the twig, and the twig on the branch and the tree, and the tree and the hole in the bog, bog down in the valley, oh, oh, ho, the rattling bog, the bog down in the valley, oh, oh, ho, the rattling bog, the bog down in the valley, oh. And on that egg there was a bird. A rare bird, a rattling bird, and the bird on the nest, and the nest on the egg, and the egg on the bird. Let's try that again. And on that egg there was a bird, a rare bird, a rattling bird, and the bird on the egg, and the egg, and the nest, and the nest on the leaf, and the leaf on the twig, and the twig on the branch, and the tree, and the hole, and the bog. Bog down in the valley, oh, oh, ho, the rattling bog, the bog down in the valley, oh, oh, ho, the rattling bog, the bog down in the valley, oh. And on that bird there was a flea, a rare flea, a rattling flea, and the flea on the bird, and the bird on the egg, and the egg, and the nest, and the nest on the leaf, and the leaf on the twig, and the twig on the branch, and the tree, and the hole, and the bog. Bog down in the valley, oh, oh, ho, the rattling bog, the bog down in the valley, oh, oh, ho, the rattling bog, the bog down in the valley, oh. And on that flea there was a, normally I would get a suggestion from the students, and it would be something really, 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 really small,
or really, really, really big.
I think a more recent one was, and on that flea there was a galaxy. A rare galaxy, a random galaxy, and the galaxy on the flea, and the flea, and the bird, and the egg, on the nest, and the nest, and the leaf, and the twig, and the branch, and the tree, and the hole, and the bog down in the valley, oh, oh, ho, the rattling bog, the bog down in the valley, oh, oh, ho, the rattling bog, the bog down in the valley, oh.
Sonia is up next with her feline fluency. Or, you could say, she's about to reveal the secret of herding cats.
My name is Sonia Olson, and I work as a classroom assistant in Minnesota River. And many of the students know that I own three cats. They're three rescue cats. A rescued barn cat, a rescued alley cat, and a rescued forest feral cat. And surprisingly, we all cohabitate quite peacefully in one home. And it is a little known fact that I am fluent in feline. Not many people know that. And I am, not to toot my own horn or anything, but I am known as the cat whisperer of St. Paul's East Side. And it's, I mean, it really does come in handy when you live with three four-legged friends. And the talent that I would like to share with you is how I trained, quite seriously, trained my cats to be less of wild beasts and become more dignified ladies of the city. And it was a long process, but through grit and patience and a whole lot of love, we got there. And it's very simple. I give a simple call, and they all come running to me. And then I ask them to organize yourself, and they do. And then I call them each out by name, and then they come forward and they eat. It's a quite a sight to behold. And you might not believe me, but I do have it on tape. It's feeding time. I have two kitties. I need three. Okay. All right. Ladies. Oh, there we are. All right, ladies, organize. Oh, get a good stretch out first. Okay, organize. Here's our first scoop. Millie. There you go. Vivian. There you go. Oh, Eunice, you are such a patient little kitty. Here we go, Eunice. There you go. Happy kitties. And that's the way it's done. Bye-bye.
Now you know all of your bids will help Great River School immensely. So thank you for taking time to place bids and make contributions. Up next, we have No Hocus Pocus, Just Focus on Maggie. This next act is impressive. I bet you never knew you lived so close to chick races. Here we go. Take it away, Natalie.
It's an excellent morning for chick racing here at Chickenberry Park. I'm Natalie, today's announcer for the 2020 Social Distancing Chick Races. It's going to be an exciting race for sure. Our racers are running afoul today in anticipation of today's race. Let's take a look at today's lineup. Timmy's no spring chicken. She hatched at least a day ahead of the others and is therefore the flavored chicken today. Timmy is a 2-week-old Easter egger from central Minnesota. Just look at the drummies on that bird. Our next racer is Oreo. She's a purebred barred rock, and her conformation is excellent, coming from good bloodlines. Here we have our last racer, Vivi, a salmon favorite, flocking to the start line. Watch for her golden streak as she runs by.
It looks like the race is about to begin.
As we enter our winner's circle and our award ceremony today, we have Oreo, who was off her game today and feeling a little peckish. She is in third place with 52 seconds. In second place is Vivi at 43.24 seconds. And our first place cup winner is Timmy, Easter Egger from Central Minnesota at 30.12 seconds. Congratulations to all of our winners.
Hey, what are you doing, Melissa?
I'm not doing anything. I was just looking at this, the stuff in this basket, the Springbrook Family Fun Basket. Have you seen this book, Heather?
No.
It's really awesome. Ultimate Book of Kid Concoctions. There's stuff like tattoo paint and ocean in a bottle. Looks like a lot of fun. There's a lot of stuff in here. I suppose I could just show you a couple. Another thing in here is full of games and activities. This looks really cool. I really, really want to open it up. I don't suppose I can, right? It's called Go Find It. It says it's an instant natural scavenger hunt game designed to get you to play outside. I can't imagine what you'd be finding. And then look at this game. It's called Tuggy. Whoops, I think I just got out. It's full of all these fun games. I just wouldn't even be able to decide which one to start with.
Where'd you get those glasses?
Oh, interesting you should ask me that. Because there's a game called Fibber, and I promise I'm going to put these back. I promise.
Thanks for checking your bids. Oh, wait, look, who's up next? It's me. Reading, give me Bach, my Schubert. Friends, I'm going to do some wordplay, word puns about geography with you. Are you ready? This book is called Jamaica Sandwich. It's by Brian P. Cleary and illustrated by Rick Dupre. Rick Dupre is from Minneapolis. So see, Jamaica Sandwich, it's did you make a sandwich? That's the only clue you're going to get for this. Here we go. Did you make a sandwich, Grandma asked, and I replied. I ate some chili from a china bowl and turkey from a plate. I know my grandma's love is real. She told me as a lad, I'll feed you when you're hungry. I'll cheer you when you're sad. I ran and played on Grandpa's farm. green land, so plush and full. I fed the pigs, milked the cows, and rode on his Stamboul. As serious scholar of baseball, my grandpa has often professed, of all the men who ever played, Babe Ruth is still the best. You ask me how's your singing, said Aunt Anna as I bowed. You know, my boy, your singing's poor, but my, you sure sing loud. Aunt Anna can fix anything. A pair of skates, a cup, if your pants rip in the knee area, just have Aunt Anna sew them up. I rush around on my red bike and feel new zeal and vigor. And when I take a kite and tie one on and sail my 10-speed rigger. Burping and belching from root beer, I made it come out of my nose. Then I shook up a can of the stuff and chugged it right down to my toes. My brother drank a malt a day and dipped his fries in grease. And though his weight was doubling, his soul seemed quite at peace. He started using sweet and low and working off his belly, but then the louse got fat again when they opened the New Delhi. We went out to the racetrack. Can you tell why I'm upset? I picked out all the winners, but my dad's too cheap to bet. My dad comes home so tired, he can't keep his bearings straight. His suit and tie land on the floor, his shoes land on his plate. You're up too late, my grandma said. You've got to get some sleep. Lie down in bed and count some whales. I think she meant sheep. Hello again. I'd like to thank all the donors who donated items for us to bid on. That was wonderful. And now for something a little different. From way downtown, all I can say is it's boom shakalaka. Here's Brent.
So for the Heron Bash talent show, I am going to share my talents of trick shots from all the years that I traveled with Dude Perfect. Check it out.
No.
Nailed it.
Over the garage.
Oh!
Throw in.
Oh! Keep going.
No,
I cut it off.
That's it. Yeah. Laying three-pointer.
Oh. Woo!
Walk-off game winner.
Boosh!
It's a home. Oh! Backspin bounce it.
Uh-oh.
What's in there?
Ah! Yeah!
I'll try this. There it is. Woo!
Ooh, what are you doing over there?
Oh, I was just looking at these games, Heather. These ones are really great. This collection from Rice Creek has so many really colorful, fun, hands-on games. This puzzle game called Genius Square, it comes with all these pieces. It just makes me think of a Montessori classroom. It looks really fun. It says you can play it by yourself or in a pair. Then there's also this Feed the Kitty game. Look at this. It comes with 20 mice. It looks really fun. And then of course there's this Bloxels game. It's way beyond me, but apparently you can create your own video game with all these colorful little squares. And then of course there's games that I recognize, like Slamwich, which is a pretty fun, fast-paced sandwich game. And Yahtzee, of course, I've played that a few times. But then there's this one. I couldn't even get it open. It's called Break Free. Looks like it has something to do with handcuffs and secret codes. This basket looks really fun. I can't believe all these fun games come in one package.
And how about that for talent? That is some talent. If you don't see something that you want to bid on, something that you can't live without, please consider making a donation. Let's take a look at Maddie and children as they share a wonderful poem by Naomi Shahib Nye, who happens to be one of my favorites.
The Arabs used to say, when a stranger appears at your door,
feed him for 3 days
before asking who he is
and where he's headed
and where he's come from,
and then he'll have strength enough to answer.
Or by then you'll be such good friends
that you don't even care.
Let's go back to that.
Rice. Pine nuts. Here, take the red brocade pillow. The child will feed your horse most short pieces of mint in your tea.
No, I was not busy when you came. I was not preparing to be busy. That's the armor everyone puts on to pretend
they have a purpose
in the world. I refuse to be claimed. Your plate is waiting. We will snip fresh mint into your tea. By Naomi Shahib Nye.
Thanks for placing your bids. Up next we have Matt, and he's going to show us that he could go all the way with his backyard.
Great River, this is Matt McElrath, the Dean of Students, and for this video I'm going to take you on a tour of my backyard and one of the hobbies that I've picked up in the last, I guess, 8 years that I've been working at Great River, and that's coincided with my time as a homeowner as well. So I have picked up woodworking, and I've adopted a house with a 40-year-old deck, stairs, steps system, about a 30-year-old fence, and this decking system goes up to what used to be a door for a second-story apartment that this past weekend I turned into a window. And so as this window gets completed, I now have 80% wood that is recyclable and a fence that needs some love. And so I am building lots of things out of this deck that include climbing walls, panels and gates for this fence, and everything that goes along with this swing set that is started here. So this swing set is something I built last summer, and this fence is going to get converted into probably a treehouse to go around this tree, perhaps a rope swinging ladder that goes on top of this flat garage roof, and some climbing walls that are going to replace fence panels, and who knows, potentially a zip line that goes from here over into our neighbor's yard. And that's about everything that I can do with wood in my small St. Paul backyard.
This might be a great place for a little intermission. You can press pause, but first, take a look at this very action-packed advertisement for a new album.
Are you ready for Now GRS Edition? Some of today's superstars in one power-packed edition. Starring modern hitmakers like Ed Sheeran. And it's chock full of Broadway classics like this one by Adele Dazeem.
Too long I've been afraid of losing love, I guess I must. Well, if that's love, it comes at much too high a cost. I'd sooner die defying gravity. Kiss me good.
You'll be hooked on the feeling of all these great hits.
I can't stop this feeling deep inside of me. Girl, you just don't realize what you do to me. When you hold me in your arms so tight, don't let me go. Everything's alright.
You'll never find yourself at a crossroads with this great mix. You'll be feeling wicked smart no matter which song you listen to. It'll be for good.
Because I knew you. Because I knew you. I have been changed.
That for talent. All right, up next we have Stacy. She eyes it. She tries it. She buys it. And it counts. Here she is.
Hello, this is Stacy checking in from Frogtown with my roommate and best friend, Padme, back here. She's lived with me for about 9 years now, and she's starting to get a little white in her muzzle. And the only reason she's sitting on the couch behind me and not on the bed in the bedroom is because I have treats for her. So, hello, Padme. I'm really just gonna check in with you and show you what I've been doing to pass some of the time. But one of the things I found is diamond art.
My diamond art canvas that I picked out was Van Gogh's Starry Night. I really enjoy that painting. If you've seen me at school, I have a keychain where the lanyard is the Starry Night, so it's a common theme for me. This is what I've done so far. So you can tell, as I come in a little bit closer, the top is all these tiny little plastic pixels that make up the hole. And then as I come down towards the bottom where I haven't finished it yet, this is a plastic covering. And then there's little symbols for each color. The grid along the side tells me which color I'm supposed to be using. And then I fill it out section by section. And so usually what I do is I take a section like this, that's about 3 inches by 4 or 5 inches, depending on how much time I have to spend on it. And then I'll peel back the plastic. And this is super sticky. And then I will start sticking the little plastic pieces to it. And then eventually here I'll work on this last strip along the bottom and finish it. So what I'm going to do today is I'm going to see if I can set up my camera to do a time-lapse video, super exciting, of me filling out this little corner section here. That's it. I hope you all enjoyed my attempt at video editing and are finding things to do to fill your time while we can't all be together doing our normal springtime activities. Take care.
Did you ever just look at a dandelion? Next up we have Sam with a song for all of us.
A short musical message about fundraising from your head of school.
Your little school could use a little dough. When you're thinking about your bank account, here's a thing you should know. Oh, if it ain't full, well, that's okay. Cause if everyone chips in a bit, you don't have to run away. And we're gonna use that money for things your kids need, like materials for the classroom and old garden seats. So just go to GOATS at 91999. And you can give. That's right, just text GOATS to 91999 and help us out. Or visit the Great River School Give page, www.greatriverschool.org/give. Thanks.
Fox went out on a chilly night, prayed to the moon to give him light. Many miles to go that night before he reached the town. Oh, town, oh, town, oh. Many miles to go that night before he reached the town. He ran till he came to the farmer's bin. Ducks and the geese kept pending. He said, couple of you gonna grease my chin before I leave this town. Oh, town, oh, town, oh. Couple of you gonna grease my chin before I leave this town. Oh. Grabbed the gray goose by the neck, swung a duck across his back, didn't mind the quack, 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 with the legs all dangling down, oh, down, oh, down, oh. He didn't mind the quack, 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 with the legs all dangling down, oh. Old mother giggle, giggle, jumped out of bed, out of the window she popped her head, crying, jump, jump. Gray goose is gone and the fox is in the town, oh, town, oh, town, oh. John, John, the gray goose is gone and the fox is in the town, oh. Johnny ran to the top of the hill, blew his horn both loud and shrill. Foxy said, I better go with my kill, they'll soon be on my tail, oh, tail, oh, tail, oh. Foxy said, I better go with my kill, they'll soon be on my tail. Foxy ran to his nice warm den, little ones there, 8, 9, 10, said, Papa, Papa, you better go back again, cause it must be probably better go back again, because it must be a mighty fine town. Oh. Fox and his wife, without any strife, cut up that goose with a fork and a knife. Never had such a dinner in their life, and the little ones chewed on the bones, oh. Oh, bones, oh, bones, oh. Never had such a dinner in their life, and the little ones chewed on the bones, oh. One more time. Never had such a dinner in their life.
Up next, we have Nadine, who shows flexibility and balance, as well as the courage, power, and grace of a mountain lion.
Hey Heather, I'm just checking out the cooking basket. I can't decide which cookbook I like better. These are both awesome. This one is The Complete Cookbook for Young Cooks from America's Test Kitchen. I just found this area here, Two Ways to Cook Bacon. Who doesn't like bacon? This is a really great book. The directions are really easy to understand. And then this one is from Rachel Ray. Rachel Ray, The Family Cookbook. It has a lot of recipes in here for lunches that kids could make on their own. I really like this one, chili cheese dogs in beach blankets. I think we've made those at my house before. Then it's got all this other great stuff, just what you need to get going. Some dish towels, an oven mitt, more dish towels. Let's see, this item, the handy chopper scraper, I love these things. You can even use these to cut brownies. And then let's see, speaking of brownies, comes with a pan and a little mini whisk, which is really great for Jell-O and chia pudding. Here we have some more muffin cups. What would you use muffin cups for? Oh, there's a muffin pan. Look at that. And a trivet made out of recycled newspapers. More pot holders. A spatula. A scraper. Peeler. And some sprinkles. This is a really great basket. I don't know how you decide. Baking, cooking, pizza. I'm not really sure. They're all pretty great.
Up next, we have Karen, who's reading a poem about Blue Earth. So those of you from the Blue Earth classroom, this one might be especially for you.
Hi, this is Karen Anway, and I'd like to wish you all a happy Blue Heron Bash, and I have a poem for you called Blue Earth. When my great-grandmother retired, she lived in a town called Blue Earth, which we visited once when I was young. I looked around eagerly to find the blue earth. Did you have to dig? But all the time we were there, the earth was brown, the grass green, and the blue sky high and unreachable as always. Still, I liked the name. It had mystery, as if it was a place where things might be different than they were at home. While my grandmother was growing up, she lived nearby in Elmore with her mother and grandparents. When she needed a dress for the prom, someone told her they were on sale in Blue Earth for $2.98. Even in 1933, that was a good price. Not a price that would purchase silk, but a price that would purchase a dress just for her. Not handed down, not worn by cousins, or sewn from cast-offs. The question was how to get there. 10 miles of dusty country roads, and no one had a car, or if they did, there was no gas. And everything was needed on the farms. So my grandmother and her best friend walked to Blue Earth to buy themselves dresses and walked back again. There was another friend, more well off, but when she heard what they had done, she returned her fancy dress and went to Blue Earth and bought a $2.98 dress. And presumably they all went to the prom in Elmore, Minnesota that spring. No one took a picture. Who could afford a camera? You hired a photographer to take a picture at a wedding, maybe, or to pose the family in front of the house. Someday when a photographer comes to the door and you have just a little bit of extra money or something to trade. They went to the prom, those three good friends, in their cheap rayon dresses. Their dates would have been boys who worked on the farm all day and then bathed in tin tubs, carefully slicking back their hair while their mothers tied lilacs or lilies into corsages. Maybe someone borrowed a car with a long-hoarded gallon of gas, and all of them packed inside for the drive to the school, laughing. They must have been laughing, I think, with such friends. They were young, strong, hopeful. Opportunities were just over the horizon, within reach. There was a price to pay, but it was not too daunting for those who were willing and humble. I never felt poor, my grandmother told me. We were always just short of money.
Are you bored with eating your vegetables? Is your lunch lackluster? Is eating salad just another item to check off of your to-do list? Well, we've got the product for you, Dressing Wow! Our dressings are like a first-class seat on a luxury airliner. Your choice of Italian, ranch, Greek, smoky seed, sesame ginger, and everyone's favorite, bang bang sauce. Get yours today for only 27 easy low payments of $79.99.
I gotta get you.
Nom nom. Who could be without bang bang sauce? Have you ever visited Montgomery? Charlie and Ariel are about to sing us a lovely song about angels from Montgomery.
Hey folks, happy Blue Heron Bash. My name's Charlie.
My name's Arielle.
And we are going to sing for you a John Prine song. John Prine was a prolific singer and songwriter who recently passed and is one of my all-time favorite artists.
The song is called Angel from Montgomery. You should sing along if you know it.
Woman named after my mother, my
man is another child that's grown old. If dreams were lightning and thunder were desire, this old house would have burnt down a long time ago. Make me an angel that flies from Montgomery. Make me a poster of an old rodeo. Just give me one thing that I can hold on to. Leaving this living's just a hard way to go. When I was a young girl, I had me a cowboy. He weren't much to look at, just a free rambling man. That was a long time, and no matter how I try, the years just float by like a broken dam. Make me an angel that flies from Montgomery. Make me a poster of an old rodeo. Just give me one thing that I can hold on to. Leaving this living's just a hard way to go. There's flies in the kitchen and I can hear them buzzing, but I ain't done nothing since I woke up today. But how the hell can a person go to work in the morning and come home in the evening and have nothing to say? Make me an angel that flies from Montgomery. Make me a poster of an old rodeo. Just give me one thing that I can hold on to. Believing this living's just a hard way to go. Hard way to go.
I'm here to ask you to help prepare our students for their unique roles as responsible and engaged citizens of the world. This COVID-19 pandemic has put an unexpected demand on our school finances, just like it has for many of us as families. And if this is a hard time for you to give, please sit this one out. No, that's okay. But if you can give now, please do. And if you can really give, now is the time to give double or increase your monthly gift. You can give online right now at the auction below. You can also place bids on community-donated goods and great gatherings. You can also just text GOATS to 91999. That's 91999, and consider becoming a monthly sustainer. Thanks. Thanks for considering it. Thanks for supporting our school.
Thanks for your attention and for bidding. This is the end of the show. It's time to go home and put the kettle on. On we go.